Hi. In the year 13,271, humankind had colonized thousands of worlds. They found none their equal as they spread into a fantastic and bountiful empire. At the height of their greatness, they walk amongst the stars as though they were gods. But gods they were not. It fell from the sky without purpose or reason. 50 worlds fell within the first day, 500 billion lives lost. Entila, 13.7 billion, dead. Sagitta, 12.2 billion, dead. Aquila, 10.8 billion, dead. Not a good stop, what would come to be called the Creeper. Pavo, 15.3 billion, dead. If it wanted nothing, it could not be reasoned with. Tselum, 20.4 billion. Canis, 5.4 billion. It seemed as though its only purpose was to undo all that man had done. But all was not yet lost. The last survivors of humanity have gathered at a world called Hope. Assembled by the visions of a crazed old man, the last of humankind marks its final hours. A great city has been built to house the 50,000 that survived. It's 49,825. It will journey from the world to world, never staying longer than it must. Guided by its path, set by the old man, humanity's final journey has begun. Commander, follow my instructions precisely. Time is crucial. So, I've played this game before. So, yeah. I already know what I'm doing. Rift completed. We have rifted to the next world. Now that our journey has begun, our goal is to leave each world as quickly as possible. On each world we visit, the Creeper will be hunting us. It has destroyed thousands of worlds and won't hesitate to destroy the few of us remain. Commander, I have some bad news. Our first rift has erased our data banks. We've lost valuable nanomachines and As we visit new worlds, we will have to collect whatever technology we find to rebuild our data banks. Scanners indicate that there is some small good news to report. There's a nanoschematic for building relays at the bottom of your console. We need to collect this tech and then activate the rift totems. I recommend building in one or two blasters and using them to push back the creeper that is headed this way from the south. Move your blasters forward slowly, a small jump at a time. Each time you jump, build collectors behind the blasters to extend your network. Once you get the nano schematic connected to your network, you will be able to build relays again. And once we can build relays, we can quickly build a network to connect to and charge the totems. Now get busy, Commander. Oh man. So I first have to get to know this game again, because Creeper World 3 is vastly different from this one. And yeah, let's see if I can still do this. I tend to pause at the beginning so I can build up the basic structures. And get going as quickly as possible. Because you need these collectors, since they give you energy. The ability to scroll and to drag. So I'm destroying these, so I don't want to overextend my power. I'm already overspending. So I have to be very careful. Well, or looking at the speed of this, I don't really have to be careful, because yeah, it's creeping pretty slow. I missed this. Enough that it reaches the emitter, you can basically disable it forever. As you can see here, it's not very effective to shoot blasters at this creeper. Or at least not the amount of blasters I have right now. So I would need much, much more blasters to get a nice result and find it. And that's it. One mission made. I will quickly stop the stream and restart it so I can have this for YouTube.